Hi, and welcome to another lesson with Master Everyday English. In today's lesson, we're gonna go and buy one of these. Yep, we're gonna go and buy a new cell phone. Today's lesson is in three parts. The first part, I'll introduce you to the vocabulary, the useful vocabulary you can use when you go and buy a new phone. In the second part, we'll listen to a conversation that uses that really important vocabulary. The conversation is between somebody looking to buy a new cell phone and a store clerk. In the third part, I'll give you just some really useful information that'll give you some knowledge that can help you when you go into the store and you want to buy yourself a new cell phone. Let's get started with that first part, which is learning the useful vocabulary you can use when you go to buy yourself a new cell phone. Carrier or service provider. This is the name for the company that's providing you with the telephone and the internet service. Data. Now this is connected to the internet and how much you use the internet. So how much you watch videos, how much you download things onto your cell phone, emails. Some companies will charge you specifically for how much data, how much internet usage you have, and it's normally in gigabytes how much they allow you to use. Storage. Well, there are different types of storage, but normally for your cell phone, by storage we just mean how many photos and videos and files you can save onto your cell phone. Cloud storage. Well, cloud storage is a separate storage service. Normally it's provided either by a separate company or it's provided by your carrier. And this is just somewhere you can save your photos and your videos. That's basically, it's just not on your cell phone. It's saved to the company's servers, the company's personal servers. 5G. 5G is the name for the speed and how reliable the internet service is that you get from the service provider. Right now, this is 2023, right now 5G is the fastest that's available. Network coverage. Network coverage is connected to how well your cell phone can connect to the internet and how good the connection is when you make a telephone call. For example, a big company will have nationwide network coverage, which means that most places you go, even if you go, you know, really out into the countryside, you can still connect to the internet on your cell phone and you can still make telephone calls. Backup. Backup just means to make an extra copy or another copy of your files, your videos, your photographs, or any of your documents. SD card. Many cell phones will allow you to place a little memory card inside so you can have more space, more memory to make more photos and more videos and save them onto your cell phone. And then you can take out that same card and transfer that information to your computer or wherever you keep your files. SIM card. A SIM card is a small chip that your service provider gives you and they place inside your cell phone, and that allows you to connect to their services, the internet and the telephone. Prepaid. This is when you pay in advance for your cell phone services. normally on a monthly basis. Postpaid. Well, this is the opposite of prepaid. This is where you pay for the services at the end of each month. Locked cell phones. When your cell phone is locked, it means that you can only use one service provider, the service provider that you have the SIM card with. Unlocked. If your cell phone is unlocked, that means that you can use it with any carrier, and it also means you can change between carriers if you want to. Switch carriers. To switch carriers means to change from one service provider to another. If you like this video and you want to see more videos about everyday life and everyday conversations in the United States, don't forget to click here and go to my channel and check out some more of my videos. Let's listen to a conversation. This is a conversation, somebody going into a cell phone store, they're looking to buy a new cell phone, and they're speaking with the store clerk trying to get some information. So listen carefully for all of that vocabulary that we just looked at.
Hi, how can I help you today?
Yeah, I'm looking for a new phone.
Okay. Are you also looking to switch carriers?
No, I don't have a phone in the US yet. Do you have any deals on right now?
We do. If you're looking to start a new plan with us, we have some great deals on phones too. How many lines are you looking for?
Two lines, one for me and another for my wife.
Okay. And what do you mostly use your phone for?
It's mostly texting and internet. I drive a lot for my job, so I use GPS too, and I take a lot of photos with my family.
Okay, it sounds like you use a lot of data. We have unlimited plans with unlimited data, talk, and text, all at the 5G speeds. If you want to back up your data, our unlimited plans also have free cloud storage. On top of that, we have some of the best network coverages in the US, which will be great for you if you're traveling and using GPS a lot.
Okay, that sounds good. How much is the plan and the phone together?
That depends on the plan and the phone you choose. The unlimited plan costs a little more, but will give you unlimited data at 5G speeds. And with that plan included in the price, you can choose from the latest iPhone or Samsung. We also have prepaid monthly plans, but that's at the 4G speed, so it's just not as high-speed data.
Okay, do I have to buy a new phone from you?
So you don't have to. You can use your own phone if it's unlocked.
Okay. I'm from the UK originally, so can I use my UK cell phone here?
Yes, you should be able to use that if it's unlocked. Our SIM card should fit into the phone. We also have eSIM where your phone will connect automatically.
Great, thank you. And could you tell me, is there a big difference between the 5G and the 4G?
If you're watching a lot of videos or gaming, it will make a difference and it might affect your GPS as well. It's just 4G is slower.
Okay. Well, it seems like the unlimited plan is probably the best for me. What cell phone do you recommend?
Well, the Samsung S21 is popular right now. It has a great camera and an SD card slot for adding extra storage. And it also has cloud access for backing up your files.
Okay, well, yeah, I think I'm gonna go with the unlimited plan.
Let me just get some details and we'll get started.
We looked at some really useful vocabulary. We listened to the conversation. So now let me give you some really useful knowledge that you can use when you go in to buy a cell phone in the United States. Who are the main service providers in the United States? It's kind of broken into two groups, really. There are a couple of really big companies, and those are Verizon, AT&T, T-Mobile. And then there are some smaller companies. For example, MetroPCS, Boost, Cricket, Mint. The larger service providers tend to be a little bit more expensive, but they have a wider range of plans. The smaller service providers normally have less plans, but they're normally a little bit cheaper than those bigger service providers. Where should I buy a cell phone? Well, you can buy cell phones in most of the big stores. Stores like Target and Walmart, they sell cell phones that are normally connected to those service providers we spoke about. Most of the large carriers and also some of the small carriers will have their own store where you can go if you specifically want to buy your services from T-Mobile. You'll be able to find plenty of T-Mobile stores where you can go and also buy a cell phone if you want to. How much will a new cell phone cost? Well, this varies depending on the cell phone. Obviously, if you want the newest cell phone, it can go as high as $1,000 or maybe more. What a lot of companies in the United States do is that they will give you the cell phone for a special price if you take a plan with them. Now, depending on the plan, you may have a monthly payment to make for the cell phone, or if you take a more expensive plan, you may get a very good discount on the price of the cell phone. Should I get a cell phone contract? Now, this has a lot to do with how you use your cell phone. If you use your cell phone a lot, if you watch a lot of videos, you use your cell phone a lot for the internet or gaming, then yes, it probably makes sense for you to have a contract. How do I change or cancel my contract? This again is different between different service providers. Most service providers will allow you to cancel your contract within the first 30 days. Most service providers will have some kind of cancellation fee if you cancel after the 30 days. If you're not happy with the service you get, it's worth speaking to another service provider, because in many cases, if you cancel and change to another provider, they will normally pay those cancellation fees for you. Now that you've bought your telephone, right, which is wonderful, congratulations, why don't you check out this video about making telephone conversations in the United States? Thanks again for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to click to subscribe.